Hello everyone, how are you? I'm Luciana, this is my YouTube channel 24 Horses Per Second, and in today's video I will show you a simple post-processing process to enhance a 3D render. Whether you are a Photoshop user or not, you'll be able to follow this tutorial. If you don't have Photoshop, you can use Photopea, which is a free online version of Photoshop. Most of the process is the same in both software, but there are some differences, so I will be covering that as well. I'll start with a simple dodge and burn process for beginners, and then a more professional approach. Later, some basic hue and saturation and contrast tweaking, and then I'll show you how to add grain and texture so your render ends up looking more realistic. First, let's start with a simple dodge and burn, but where is it? With the dodge and burn technique, you can lighten or darken areas of the image. This technique is used in photography to retouch skin or to create volume. In this case, I will use it to get rid of these shadows that don't look good, but you could use it to create more volume in the image too, and I mostly did some dodging because I needed to lighten those shadows, but you could also do some burning to enhance those shadows. In both Photoshop and Photopea, you have these icons here to dodge if you want to brighten something or burn to darken. This is the easiest way, but it's not the best way of doing it. With right click, you can change the brush size or hardness settings. Or you can do it in here. And you can also change the exposure. The most exposure, the most notorious the dodge or burning will be. And here you can choose whether the effect will change the highlights. Midtones. Or shadows. Now I'm actually gonna show you a more proper way of dodging and burning. For that, I'll make a new layer with 50% gray in soft light blending mode. As you can see, a 50% grain layer with soft light blending mode is basically invisible. In Photoshop, you just press Alt in this layer icon or go to New Fill Layer and just put the same settings we just did. We just have to choose the brush and paint with black if we want to make shadows, or with white to make highlights, or any in-between gray shade too. And if you mess up, you just have to paint with 50% gray in the parts you want to erase. We could make the shadows more noticeable with black. There are different types of adjustment layers. I'm gonna go with brightness and contrast and with hue and saturation. And these are just going to be subtle changes. And if you wanted to change this at any point, you just click here and you can change the values. In Photoshop, to add an adjustment layer, click the same icon that in Photopea. Now let's add some grain, and here we have two different ways to do it because there's one tool that is missing in Photopea. So for Photoshop, first we are making a new layer and converting it in a smart object, because that way we can change the settings at any moment, just like with adjustment layers, but in this case is with an effect. Choose the effect fill blur. First, add some blur, which won't make any changes to the image because we have a 50% gray image, so don't worry. And then you can add the grain. These are my settings, but you can change them depending of your taste and the size of your photo. The bigger the photo, the bigger the size and the amount of noise usually. And like I said, you can click the layer and change the settings at any minute. Now grain in Photopea, just make a new layer and fill it with 50% gray with an overlay blending mode. You can convert the layer into a smart object just like in Photoshop, so you can change the values of the noise effect at any moment. And let's add noise. And you can lower the opacity too. And if you left click in the noise effect, here are the settings in case you want to change them. And last but not least, let's add film dust texture. First, search for dust overlay. Make sure the image is not too small. Right click, copy image. Ctrl B to paste it. Choose screen as the layer blending mode. And if the dust is too visible, you can lower the opacity. That will be the simple way of doing it. But if you want to be a little bit more precise, and this is what I did, create a mask. And now if there's a part of the image where you want less dust, paint with black. And if you want to erase what you did, you just paint with white. And you can always lower the opacity of the brush so you don't erase entirely the dust. You will have a subtle dust. And in Photoshop, where I have my original file with all the edits, I'm gonna show you how the dust overlay looks after I erase the parts where I wanted the dust to be less intense. And to export the image, just go to File, Export as PNG or JPEG. And to save this file with all these effects, just save it as PSD. And to save the file in Photoshop, you could go to Save As, but I usually choose Save for Web, because after some trial and error, this is the best for the photos I upload to Instagram. I suggest you look more into it. There's plenty of tutorials on YouTube about saving your file for social media so the app doesn't change your colors. And I also suggest you read about image formats, why or when to choose save as PNG or JPEG. I also have a previous video on how to light this still life 3D render. And that's it for today's video. I hope this was helpful. As always, you can check out my Instagram. I'm working on some new stuff I think you might like, so make sure to subscribe to this channel if you want to take your renders to the next level while learning about light and color. Bye!